3-7, using equations to solve percents. First thing we need to learn is some terms. What number means x? That's your variable. It's the thing you're looking to solve for. Of means times. It means to multiply. We've talked about that in yesterday's lesson. Is means equals to. From here, we can take and look at a word problem. What percent of 48 is 15? The what percent part, that's the same thing as saying what number. And we established that what number equaled x. Your of means times. 48 is, of course, going to be 48. Is means equals. And 15 means 15. From here, you've got a simple one-step equation. Your variable's x, his friend is 48. 48 is multiplying itself times x, so we're going to isolate our variable by dividing both sides by the 48. The 48's on the left cancel each other out, and when you divide 15 by 48, you get 0 and 3,125 ten-thousandths. So we're done now, right? Well, maybe not. The problem asks for a percent. Do you have a percent here? No, you do not. You have a decimal. Of course, changing a decimal to a percent is real easy. Ba-doop, ba-doop. Bounce the decimal two spaces to the right. Throw down your percent sign. Now you've answered your question properly. 31 and 25 hundredths percent. Easy math. Here's another one. What is 20% of 40? Well, what? That's the same thing as saying what number, so that's your variable. Your is, of course, means equals. 20%, 20% of means times, and the 40 comes down. Now, don't get too excited about the whole isolating your variable thing here, because you can see, wait, my variable's already isolated. He's all alone. So sad. So now we don't have to worry about isolating him. We just got to multiply 20% times 40. How do we multiply a percent times a whole number? We change it to a decimal. 20% is the same thing as 0.2. 0.2 times 40, that's going to be 8. Circle your answer. All there is to it. Easy math. Remember, if the problem asks for a percent, then you have to change your decimal answer to a percent. This is important. It's in red. Also in red, if the problem gives you a percent, you must change it to a decimal before you can do anything with it. Very important concepts to remember there. You pause the recording and work on this one. Okay, what percent of 120 is 36? The what percent, that's going to be your variable, of means times, 120 is means equals 36. From here, we're going to isolate our variable by dividing 120 on both sides. Right there. Bye-bye. Canceled out. X is all by as we would have wanted them. 36 divided by 120 is 0.3. Quick reminder on where that came from. The first number would go on the house. 120 goes into 36, 0 times. Bring in your decimal and your 0. Your decimal goes up. 120 goes into 360. 3 times, which is 360 with nothing left over. 0.3 or 3/10 is your answer, but you're not done. Problem asked you for a percent, so we've got to change that to a percent. Ba-doop, ba-doop, throw down a percent sign. Now we're done. Circle, of course, you do want to circle it to say, hey, there it is. Find my answer. 12% of a number is 9. 12% of what number is 9? Pause that one. Work it out. All right. The 12%, of course, comes straight down. Of means times. What number is your variable? Is means equal. And 9 is 9. From there, we're going to take and change our decimal or our percent to a decimal. We can't do anything really with it till we've done that. So that's the same thing as saying 12 hundredths. We're going to divide both sides by the 12 hundredths to isolate our variable. Cancels out here, which is going to leave me with x is equal to 75. How did I get that? Well, this part right here, the first number went in the house. The 0.12, I bounced the decimal two spaces to the right. I bounced this decimal two spaces to the right, annexing zeros, moving my decimal straight up. 12 went into 90 seven times, which is going to be, let's see here, 5 is, times 12 is 60, plus 24 is going to become 74. And when you find the difference there, that's going to leave us with, oh, my remote's rebooting, hold on, pause, all right, we're ready. That will leave us with 16 left over. And then when you bring the 5 in, 5 times 10, 2 is of course 10, 5 times 1 is, oh, I goofed, where'd I goof at? 60, 70, that should have been 84, so I would have just had 60 left over. And there's your other 6, which would have given you nothing left over, and that way you got your 75 for your final answer. Easy math. Here's a quick little review from earlier in the lesson. To write that number as a percent, pause your recording, show me you know how it's done. For that one, I just multiply top and bottom number by 4 because it's 25 is a factor of 100. That means you get 16 one-hundredths, also known as 16%. That one, pause the recording and work on it. For this one, you've got to take and do it the hard way. You got to divide the numerator by your denominator. When you do that, you get 0 and 375 thousandths, but we have to change that decimal to a percent. Bounce, bounce, 37.5%. Easy math. Your assignment for this lesson is going to come out of your textbook. You need to go to the textbook website, which is my.hrw.com. In order to find it, of course, you need your login and username. Make sure you still have that. Page 321, 9 through 24, odd.
Mexico City, Mexico. Plaza de Toros. Trumpets sound the traditional introduction of the bull. But when Pajarito enters, there will be no bullfight. At least, not in the ring. Without warning, the 1,000-pound beast charges right into the stands. It's an incredibly powerful leap. Spectators scramble for their lives. It's chaos. The bull lowers his razor-sharp horns and goes in for the goring. Fans don't stand a chance against the enraged animal. Suddenly, he savagely spears an elderly woman. And with all her might, she holds on to the bull's killer horn. Somehow, she pushes herself clear. Matadors finally get control before anyone is killed. These fans came to watch a matador's victory over a bull. Today, the bull got his revenge.
Mm-hmm.